Hi, this is Mike Sayers. I'm an original co-founder at Mechanical Simulation, and I'm going to show you some of the big vehicles that we can do in TruckSim. This is a lead unit with three axles, with a semi-trailer that has an axle, and then a full trailer, which means it has a dolly and a semi-trailer on top of it. This can be set up automatically from our GUI in here. We have a screen for the vehicle combination with options for up to two trailers. When we go and look at this, we see this is the lead unit with three axles. Here's the semi-trailer. It does have a hitch in the back so that we can extend the vehicle out. It does not have a dolly. And here is the second trailer, which does have a dolly and does not have a trailing hitch. So it's just basically checking the right boxes, selecting data sets, and you're good to go. Now here's another vehicle that's big in a different way. It's just a tractor semi-trailer hauling a wind turbine blade, which as you can see is huge. And it's faced with a 90 degree turn in the road here. With normal unsteered rear, with normal unsteered trailer suspensions, there would be huge off-tracking, but these are steered wheels. As you can see that they're steering in order to sort of keep the back suspensions on the pavement, and it will navigate the curve. We'll look into the data here, and we'll see that we are using VS commands to augment the model to include steering of those trailer wheels. That was how they're put in, and we can see them echoed in the echo file here, which is easier to read because of the syntax coloring. And you can see it's not very complicated. We're basically looking at the lateral tracking and steering to minimize that. Now here's a vehicle that's big in a different way. Look at the model layout up there. There are a lot of S's. That's because it's got lots of axles. In fact, when we go to the model summary here in the echo file, we see that there's only one vehicle, but it's got nine axles. Now, our GUI doesn't support a screen that has nine axles on a lead unit, but our models do. Our solvers can support many trailers and many axles per trailer. So one of our developers, Dave Hall, put this together by using generic screens in TruckSim to assemble this big vehicle. It has nine axles. The rear five are driven. As it goes over these bumps, you see the load sharing effects on some of the suspensions. It's a combination of some tritums and tandem suspensions in there, and the rear five wheels are driven. Now we've seen we can put a lot of axles on a unit. You might wonder how many trailers can we put behind to make a train. Well, the answer is a lot. In this case, we have 15 trailers following the lead unit, so we have a total of 16 vehicle units in this run. Here is the summary from the echo file made at the end. You see that there are 16 vehicle units there. It means 15 trailers. And there's another number of interest. Our time is 0.5. That means that we ran two times faster than real time in this simulation. Well, that's showing you some big trucks in TruckSim. Thank you for watching.